Welcome everybody, my name is Philippe, François, Jacques, and today I'm going to show you how to make a perfect Valentine's Day for you and your, your woman. So let's go to the kitchen, let's go. So, what I have prepared here today, we are going to start with a little simple thing that will make your woman's heart melt, which is called the baguette. You know the baguette back here in France, back home, is the best thing. Your woman would love it. She will not regret the day that she has not eaten some baguette. So what we're gonna start with is we're gonna grab these little pieces of baguette mix, and then we're gonna add it to the flour. So we go like this, and then like that. We add a little bit of flour, like this. That's a little bit too much, but it works still either way. So you mix it up. Oh yes, this is exactly what I want. Oh yes, I love that feeling of baguette mix in your hand when you are mixing it. It feels like a true achievement when you are making the baguette yourself. Now, the problem here is taking out the baguette of your hands. Sometimes it gets
sticky.
Too sticky. Cameraman, this is my video. Shut the hell up. So we are gonna add some more ingredients to the recipe. Oh my god. So what we are gonna use is a little bit of peanut butter, extra de vanille, which is a vanilla extract. We are going to use some sugar, some salt, vinegar. This is perfect recipe for baguette. Some chicken stock. So that's what we're gonna be using. So let's come back over here. Here we have my famous cutting board. And what we are going to do first, before putting the baguette mix into the cutting board, we're going to add the ingredients. We are going to add a little bit of this. Oh, that looks yummy. I can smell, the smell, amazing. We're going to add a little bit of vanilla extract. So after that, we are going to grab a little bit of peanut butter. Grab it, it won't come off the spoon. Sometimes you have to be a little violent with the food because they are being stubborn. This freaking peanut butter, there you go. In stock, this plays a big part in the baguette mix, that I can tell you. It seems we're at the chicken stock, so we are going to have to forget that part. You do not want to add so much sugar because, you know, diabetes, so you want to be careful. So you're gonna add a little pint of sugar. So that's perfect, that's a little bit, it's not too much.
That's a lot.
This is my show, cameraman. You need to learn to shut your mouth. You can smell. Oh, it smells amazing.
Are you sure, man?
Yes.
You're gonna throw up.
No, bruh. You tripping. So after that, we are going to grab all of it, and we're gonna put it here into one little cutting board. So look at this. You put it like that. You have here. There you go. There is your baguette. So what we are going to do with the baguette now is we are going to put it on the cutting board. Oh, look at my baguette. It looks amazing, it looks delicious. You are going to preheat the oven. I did not preheat it, but my oven is professional, so I do not need to preheat. But you put it at your normal 350 degrees, the timer. You put it to 10 minutes, perfect. You put it in here, no problem whatsoever. So we are going to make great use of the rest of the time while it's in the oven, and we are gonna go decorate the table. Come with me, let's go. So we got perfectly good for the table. You want to decorate the table as much as you can. You know, you want to make good use of this. You want to spread it in the whole table.
Whoa!
It's okay, whoa. We are going to cut that out of the video. No one will see ever that Jacques fell. It's okay. The thing about women is that they like to taste different kinds of things when they're eating something. So me, Jacques, I invented something. I call it the spice wheel. What you do is you turn it and then you go boop. This is the spice we are going to use tonight. But if your girl likes to variate so many stuff in one night, just bring the whole wheel to her. So we are going to go set that on the table. Let's go. So we are going to use this, the weapon wheel. Look, we've got some good stuff in here. We have some sarriente, cinnamon, romarin. We got your average salt.
Do you need glasses?
No, I do not. My glasses, I broke them. But it does not matter. We got some fennel, some thyme, some jaws, oregano. Salt and pepper you cannot live without. So let's go back into the kitchen and get some more stuff. So out of the fridge, we have some fresh wine. It's not the bottle, it's homemade. So it's a Jacques special.
Homemade is the best.
Philippe, Jacques, François, special, you know. He respect, put some respect on my name. Let's go. We are going to grab, we are not going to serve it so much because we need to be careful with wine. Wine, if you spill a lot on the table, it's going to stain, and this is white. So if it gets stained, my mama's going to kill me because this is hers. She told me to be careful with it. So I'm going to try my best and I'm trying to be careful with it. So, oh, I love the wine. You know, one good tip is when you are drinking wine, you like to smell it first. You like to savoure dans ton nez, which means you like to savour it in your nose. You know, it goes through the sinus in your brain and your brain is like, that is some good wine. But this is homemade, so the scent is gonna be stronger. All your five senses will be heightened. It's gonna be a crazy night. So we are gonna pour a little bit of wine. Oh, did I spill some on the table? We are going to, you know, that looks amazing. So one thing your woman will love is to be separate at the table. At Valentine's Day, if you want your woman to cuddle with you all night, the secret is to keep each other away. So at the end of the night, you can cuddle and have a romantic night. Because she's going to stay away from you for so long, she's going to want to be with you the whole night, you understand? Philippe got this in the bag, you understand? Philippe done this already, he knows everything, all the tips and tricks. That's why I'm here, to help you out.
You know, François, I have problems with my girlfriend.
That's not my problem, let's go back to the
kitchen. Wait. Maybe you can cook for me or... for Valentine's Day, you know?
That'll be $1,500. What? So one of the most ideal things for a romantic dinner is you get your wife a candle. If your wife is being nice to you, you give her the big candle. If she tell you are a worthless man that cannot cook for crap, you give her the little one, you understand? So let's light it up. So it's not working, so it's okay. If the candle does not work, go to plan B and get her the little candle. The only little problem is I do not want to burn the table. If I burn the table, my wife is going to cut off my croissant. So what we are going to do, we go little lightly. You know what? Screw the candle. My wife is not nice to me anyway. Let's go check on the baguette. Okay, so another trip for Valentine's Day to impress your wife. One of the ideal number one things, like the thing you cannot forget, that if you forget, your wife will be so mad. It's like forgetting your... Oh, the baguette is ready, let's go! So let's go get the baguette. Apparently the baguette is ready. Let's go see. Oh my lord. Woo!
Sorry, I'm getting too excited.
Oh my lord, this is a perfect creation. Look at this. Look at that. So let's cut the baguette.
Are you sure you're professional?
Yes. What we are going to do, we are going to cut the baguette into little pieces. We are going to, you know, just cut through it. Oh, look, you hear that crunchiness, my friend. Oh my god. We're just going to cut pieces.
Can I have one? Right?
Get out. So we are going to keep cutting the pieces. Evenly cut. Look, one each piece for every family member. Well, either way, it's just your wife. So you get half. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 10 pieces, 5 for each. In this, make it very romantic. It fits in the plate. It fits in the plate, so it works. Let's go. So we are going to bring this to the table. And we are going to do this. Get rid of the spices a little bit.
Wow.
Separate it. Look at this. Just wait a second. I'm having a little bit of the careful key. The baguette is being ridiculous with me. But either way, we go like this. We got the baguette. Half for each. And there, you have your romantic date with your wife or your girlfriend or whoever it is. I think my wife is going to be very happy that I did not burn down our last house like last time. And I think it's going to be a big... Oh! Wait! I almost forgot. Le fromage. So what we are going to do, we are going to grab le fromage.
Move!
Why do you disrespect me like this? What we are going to do, we are going to grab the fromage and we are going to put it on the plate. So what we are going to do, we are going to put some fromage on it. Seriously, I like this one. This is, I think this is blue cheese.
No, that's cheddar.
Do not contradict me, this is blue cheese and I know it. So we are going to grab a little bit and we are going to spread it all over the croissant. Over time, because the croissant is still hot, when you take it out of the oven, you want to do that right away so the cheese can melt. Melt instantly. Oh, malheur. Just, you know what? I think this beautiful croissant deserves a montage.
That's
you know?
Not a croissant, that's a baguette.
Yes, my baguette. Thank you for the correction. Once again, cameraman, thank you for contradicting me once again. I'm seriously going to cut off the tongue and feed it to the dogs. So, cameraman, now that you're such a smart mouth, why don't you have a piece of my baguette and let's see how it tastes. Are you ready to have one?
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
You better. So, you know what? Take a piece. Here, try it for yourself. Here you go, take a little piece. Tell me what you think. 100% quality. Oh! Cameraman!
I'm about to quit, man.